Welcome to NBA Playoff Basketball on 2K Sports. I'm Ernie Johnson. Got Kenny the Jet Smith, got Shaquille O'Neal. Time to get ready for this crucial Game 4 of the opening round. Tonight, it'll be the Atlanta Hawks going up against the Pistons in Detroit. And guys, for the Pistons, Game 3, a bitter loss. These home fans hoping they can rally back and provide something to cheer about this time around. And Kenny, a monster elimination game tonight. If you're the underdog and fighting for your playoff lives, what do you do to turn the tide in this series?
Oh, you got
to
play like there's no tomorrow, Ernie. Every 50-50 ball, those are those balls that are just rolling down the court. You got to get those. Every second chance opportunity will win. So, you know, those small battles win the big war.
You know, it takes only one big win to get that momentum back on your side. That happened for me and D-Wade back in 06 when we were down against Dirk. And the Mavericks, 02, came back and won.
And that is it for
us. Can you dig it?
As we send you to Kevin Harlan and the rest of the 2K Sports crew.
What is going on, you guys? It is your boy, Jaren, and we're back playing some more NBA 2K16, my career. This is game 4 of the playoffs. The series is 3-0, and if we do win game 4 over the Detroit Pistons, we advance to round 2, the semifinals. So let's get that W. But while we're doing this gameplay, as you guys know what the title is of the video, let's talk about Kevin Durant joining the Golden State Warriors. Now, when I heard about this, well, I heard about this when I was uploading yesterday's gameplay of NBA 2K16. I was uploading, and then when I looked at my phone, I looked on Facebook, it says, Kevin Durant is now joining the Golden State Warriors. And my reaction was like, what? For real? This can't be real. Like, that was my reaction. And then when I saw all over ESPN and Stephen A's giving his thoughts on Kevin Durant joining the Golden State Warriors, and I was like, wow, this is actually real. It's actually true. Kevin Durant is now joining the Golden State Warriors. Now, my thoughts on that is like, wow, it's real shocking. And now my thoughts like, now the Golden State Warriors are going to be the toughest team to beat next season. And you know, all the other teams like the Cleveland Cavaliers, the Miami Heat, among others, the San Antonio Spurs. Speaking of the San Antonio Spurs, they got Paul Gasol, because I'm hearing now that Tim Duncan is retiring. But yeah, of course, the San Antonio Spurs, possibly the Los Angeles Lakers, the LA Clippers. And of course, as you guys all know, I can't forget about the Oklahoma City Thunder. They're gonna be tough to beat, like the Golden State Warriors, because now they have Kevin Durant. And Kevin Durant is now joining the Golden State Warriors, the team that beat him in the Western Conference Finals. They were down, they come back 3-1 in the series, and they won. The Golden State Warriors beat Kevin Durant.
And if you look at the numbers, guys, I mean, what jumps out at you is the
I don't know, man. I'm doing this video. It was just one day ago. I just had to give my thoughts to it because I just heard about it while I was uploading yesterday's gameplay video. So that's all I got to say about that. Let's hope that Golden State, yeah, we're pretty sure that now Golden State Warriors is going to be the toughest team to beat now this season. Possibly they could win the NBA championship next season. That could be it. Because now Kevin Durant's on there. And also heard about the Golden State Warriors, they trade Andrew Bogut, the injured Andrew Bogut, because of Kevin Durant. And also hearing that also, like I said, Paul Gasol is now with the San Antonio Spurs. I think that's the best one out of all. Better than Derrick Rose. But not as top as Kevin Durant joining the Warriors. But the San Antonio Spurs, that's like the biggest pick to have for the team, is because, you know, Tim Duncan is now possibly retiring, ending his historic career. I think that's a good thing. And that's all I got to say right now. And that's his first foul. I just can't believe it. Durant's joining the Warriors. And you know, I can tell on the look of react on LeBron James' face that he's laughing, he's crying, and he's pissed off because it's all his fault. Because he's the one that started this. He's the one that started this whole thing of players in this position. And I can't blame him. And it's, I just can't blame him. Because he is the first one to do this when he joined, when he left Cleveland to go to Miami. And, but there's an opposite of LeBron James leaving than Kevin Durant. It's because LeBron James left Cleveland is because it was just LeBron James on that team and a bunch of nobodies. And he, it was just him on his own. Like, there, back then, there was no Kyrie Irving on that team. There was no J.R. Smith. It was just him. And I can and we all know why he left. Left to go to Miami. But for Kevin Durant on the other side, it's kind of a bandwagon. It's, well, for other people, from other fans' perspective, it's a bandwagon move. Like Stephen A. said it, it was a bandwagon move. And he's also said, like, it's the weakest. Weakest decision by Kevin Durant. Yeah, he gets his opinion. We can't blame him. We all know how he feels. No disrespect to Stephen A. He's a great guy. But I know you fans are pretty much upset about it. I saw other other people on YouTube, like Cash Nasty, gave his thoughts. Chris Move, King Sean. I think how you say that, right? Yeah, I saw all of them. Gave their thoughts on Kevin Durant joining the Warriors. And I know all you fans, other fans, are upset about it. I know Warriors fans are happy about it. The Cavaliers fans might be upset about it. And you know damn well that the Oklahoma City Thunder, Oklahoma City fans are pretty much upset about it. And you know when Kevin Durant goes back to Oklahoma to challenge the Thunder, you know the fans are going to boo him. Who knows if they're going to boo him or cheer him? Who knows? But is the league going to have a bunch of heat? Like a bunch of, a lot of focus to the Golden State Warriors like they did with the Miami Heat? I'm pretty sure it is. They're going to have a bunch of, like, controversy? I don't know if that's the right word to say.
Here's Jokic. Muhammad covering.
Or, like, I was not... How about say attention? Is the league going to have a lot of attention to the Golden State Warriors over the Miami Heat since now Kevin Durant is with the Warriors? And that's all I got to say about that. That's all my thoughts. I'm just shocked that Kevin Durant is joining the Warriors. And that's all I got to say. And let's get right into the game. Let's talk about the game. Let's get right into it. Look at this. I'm wide open. Bucket.
Go now to the sideline and catch up with Doris Burke. Hey, Doris.
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Pistons had a huge game. He had 55 points, and that was just the start of it, notching a triple-double for his effort in what was quite a display from him. Absolutely amazing numbers from him in what was truly a memorable performance for him and for us, Kevin.
Great job, Doris. Thank you, guys. It's going to be very interesting to see if he can stay in a role like that tonight.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes those hot streaks can last for days, and I'm sure they'll be feeding him the basketball, hoping he's still got that mojo working.
Well, they ought to. I mean, when you've got a thoroughbred like him, I think you've got to ride him for as long as he'll carry you.
Let's bring up the 2K leaderboard so we can look at the highest scoring teams in the NBA during the regular year. It's number one.
I tell you what, Kevin, they've got to be really pleased.
Right, let's
with
skip this. Let's get back into the game.
In terms of point production, I mean, they found scoring opportunities and made the most of them as a team.
We're up by eight in the second quarter.
Been doing in the offseason has clearly paid off.
And the Hawks making a
let's
change.
Get that good screen.
Checked in.
Pick and roll, baby. I'm wide open. Mid range. Puts it in.
The jump shot. To
to the right side. Find the shoot.
Al Horford.
14 points for Al Horford.
Boy, this has been a terrific stretch.
Yo, Al Horford, second quarter. He's got 14 points, and he has more points than me right now.
Tonight, 4 of 7 shooting. Picked by Bargnani. There's the double team with Korver. Jackson has the
Jackson.
And Detroit again with the
bubble. That's a 2.
The rest of the D can be stretched a little thin with the double teams in place like that.
Yo, man. Pistons are still in it. They want to keep their season alive. The layup. They're still in it. They're still trying to keep their season alive. But we're depressing not to let that happen. We want to win the championship. We want to go on round two. The championship's mine. Paint open. Fuck it.
Now, that was an incredible reverse throwdown right there. Tremendous body control.
Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes played. Pass to Scott. He kicks to Korver. Shoots from 12.
Horford misses. Get the ball. Oh, cool. Wow. What? I wasn't even getting blocked. No one was right in front of me. And I missed that?
Jackson with it. 10 points for him.
Easy. Oh. Coming off the pit. Time out. Oh, man.
Just a 1 point Atlanta
lead. 1 point game.
We're playing too much on the perimeter. Let's look to dump the ball inside.
And with a break of the four. Let's see which point guards were the best distributors during the regular season.
Yeah, we know about that. Let's skip that.
The assist leaders among them.
Let's skip that.
Jackson, one of the best passers in the NBA, always looking to get his teammates involved.
And obviously assists are the name of the
game. Oh, look at that. Look at that.
And that's not
beautiful.
These guys. It's all about making their teammates better.
I agree. I mean, their vision.
Look at that amazing ball movement right there.
They have with their teammates. It really adds
that was sexy.
Wealth of understanding of what to do out there, and it makes them a special group.
Turnover.
Pass break here. Here come the Hawks.
Pass it in. Al Horford. Oh, he misses.
And typically, he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that position.
Caldwell Pope kicks to Jackson. Pistons passing it around.
He's left him wide open.
Elbow shot
nope. Oh, Bargnani.
That's good from Bargnani.
And that lead pass allowed him to get straight to the rim, unabated.
Oh, risky right. Pass. Put it in. Oh, Horford, there we go. Take that assist. He missed it the last time. He got it in this time.
He has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
Outside Jackson.
And that pick and roll.
To the inside.
Drummond.
And that one is hammered home.
Solid on the one-hand throw down there.
You know, Clark, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Yep. Yeah, and one reason why. I just don't know that I've ever seen him miss a play like that.
That's a
Kyle Korver.
Wide open shot is on the money. Korver's got his second basket.
The dimer.
Pistons trailed.
He wasn't even that open.
Turner dishes to Caldwell.
I think he had that. All that space.
It's stolen by Korver.
Oh, another turnover.
You got it. Let's get the ball inside.
Pass it in. Mike Scott, you know what it is. Bingo.
Mike Scott's got 11 points. Drummond the screen. 4 on the clock.
Oh, Drummond's open. Oh, I got the foul. And one. No. And of course, Drummond. He's gonna miss it.
And then gets the basket.
He didn't even touch the rim.
Comes in for Bargnani. And Shabazz Muhammad subbed in for Evan Turner.
I always, it seems like all the free throw line, I just jinx him. Or maybe he's just a terrible free thrower in the game. Like he is in real life. I don't know if he is a bad free thrower in real life. Because I don't watch the Pistons. Even though the Detroit Pistons is my teacher from high school's favorite team. I have no mind about that, but still.
And
trying to come up. This is my teacher's favorite team from high school. Horford. There we go. How many points Al Horford has? I think I have. He has 18 points. Holy shit. This is like the first time he's Al Horford's got more points so far in the season.
Atlanta with the rebound. James got his seventh rebound here tonight. Jokic passes to James.
Or maybe it's because I'm passing the ball in this game. That's why Al Horford's getting the points. Just give Al Horford yet again 20 points.
Shooting so far.
All right.
He's having quite the quarter here, guys. I mean, shooting the ball extremely well.
How's I would even mind Al Horford getting the Jordan Player of the Game, which is actually not gonna happen because I'm the guy.
He feeds it to Harris.
Harris Horford with the block.
And he recovers it. Will it go?
Misses. I got the board and the foul on Drummond. Pick and roll.
Outside team.
Never mind, Nico's out, got it. Dudley is open, puts it in. 12 points.
Man, they came out smoking here from beyond.
And Greg, as hot as they are from out there, absolutely no reason at all not to just keep letting them fly.
Johnson the screen.
Drummond misses.
That's something they need to do more of. Get after it on the glass. Go get those boards.
Oh, Drummond, you disrespect. How dare you?
And maybe swing the momentum.
Detroit's gotten a success rate of just over 50% from 3-point tonight. 4 of 7 shooting. Jackson up top. 12 points for him.
Jackson misses it. Good defense.
And you know, you can feel the desperation.
There was no reason for Dudley to spin.
To lose their composure offensively.
Yeah, it's palpable, Greg. I mean, clearly you can see the frustration. And it's understandable.
Paint open.
I mean, right now they're on the wrong
side. Look at Jeff Teague.
That's good.
They are just killing them on the interior.
The Hawks leading by 15. About 7 seconds.
About to end the third quarter. One more quarter left before we advance.
That's his first foul.
Yeah, that's a tough call right there. And really a tough break for the D.
Greg, no problem for me with that call. I mean, he was still sliding right there.
And the Pistons making
the Pistons can have one more quarter left to keep their season alive. With 15 point lead. Pick and roll. Oh, disrespect. You're leaving me wide open from downtown.
He's got a pair of threes now here in the third for the Hawks.
That's disrespect. You're just leaving me open. Oh, shot clock. Cheese. Bam. Bucket.
Jackson's got 8 points in the quarter. Well, through three quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. It's Atlanta up by 16. Don't go anywhere. The final quarter is coming up next on 2K Sports. Welcome back as we get.
All right, it is now the fourth quarter.
Round one playoff matchup. Pistons trail by 16. Tobias
can the Detroit Pistons come back? And I'm pretty sure I'm going to get benched in is because I can't stay there that long. I was there the whole third quarter. Coach got to give me a rest. Look at the block by Al Horford. Two blocks in the game.
Scott dishes to Schroeder. It's
deflected. Oh, with the tip. Oh, I'm wide open from downtown. The dagger yet again.
Fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for the Hawks.
And I was benched in, and I'm back in with 5 minutes left of the fourth quarter. And look at the lead we have.
There's the pick.
I'm wide open. This time, not from downtown. That was a two. Oh yeah, look at me. Look at those muscles.
Nice pass that time. What excellent vision.
19 point lead. Yo, man, what happened when I was benched in? Then my team just basically were shooting? Oh, the paint's open.
And he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
How about that now? What a sensational.
Yeah, man, we're gonna get game four with a W.
You got it. Let's get the
ball. By a pull away lead. I don't know what happened to the Pistons when I was benched.
Outside Korver.
They must have gave up or something. Cause my team was shooting. Looking like just like that. Kyle Korver.
4 points now in the quarter.
And those are the kind 20 point game with 3 minutes right left. Oh, maybe I'm just going to let my team shoot. I'm just let my boy shoot the ball. Because I basically done everything I had. Maybe I can get like one more three into this. That's a risky pass. Oh, and one.
He's come out here in the second half and done a nice job.
And one.
Getting good looks and finding his range.
That's good. And Caldwell Pope drops them both. Atlanta leads.
Yeah, we're definitely gonna.
17. Kicks to Cephalosha.
I'm definitely gonna have to get one more shot in. One more three. That's all I need. I need like 35 points.
It's Scott.
I need one more three.
Now the pass to Jay. Six on the shot clock. Left side, Korver.
I said a Kyle Korver for three, puts it in.
Five on a five for eight night shot.
Wow.
And really, I like the fact that even with the big lead, they never coached.
Oh, look at Reggie Jackson. Oh, he misses.
You should always be
playing
against the game and yourself. I know there's
not. Oh, they forgot about me. They already forgot about me. There it is.
Stay true to that. And I like that aggressive
with the fader.
Speed ahead. Kind of attack that they have. And guys, just really impressed. They made big plays when it counted, and that's why it's going to be on to the next round for the Hawks.
The sheer volume of three-pointers was the deciding factor tonight, it seemed.
Yeah, they sink one, Kevin, and then they do it again. Work.
And what a huge standout performance it was for Jay. And you have to love the effort he put forth on the glass. He played with a fire no one else could match. As he chased down those rebounds.
The drive by Scott.
You know, there are a lot of bigger power forwards than him in the NBA, but very few that rise up like he can.
The game is over. We're going to walk game four with a W and advance to round two, the semifinals. We sweep over the Detroit Pistons with four games, including game two we won in overtime. We'll see you in round two.
And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Well, once again, you find yourself with a points and rebounds double-double. Is that something you've come to expect from yourself on a nightly basis?
I don't know that reaching certain benchmarks like a double-double means much. But I always expected myself to come out and bounce and rebound, take good shots. This is how I shot to play for this team.
Well, thank you for your time. Kevin, we'll see what the rest of the league has to say about that.